HIV, how to assess a child. If a child is at risk of HIV or has signs and symptoms of HIV, this is not a mild illness that can be treated at home. You will assess the child to determine if they have a moderate or severe illness. In both cases, the child needs to be referred to a health facility. Start by asking the caregiver questions about the child's symptoms. Number one, find out if the child has been exposed to HIV. Ask the parents if they have been tested for HIV or have had exposure to a person with HIV. It's important for the mother to know her HIV status, as HIV can be transmitted from a mother to her infant during pregnancy, labor and delivery, and from breastfeeding. It is also important for the father, if he is present, to know his status. If they do not, refer them for HIV testing. If one or both parents are living with HIV, but the child has not been tested, refer the child for HIV testing. If the mother is living with HIV and breastfeeding the child, ask her if she is taking antiretrovirals or ARVs. It is essential to take these medications properly to reduce the amount of virus in the body and prevent transmission to her child. Exclusive breastfeeding for at least 6 months is recommended if the mother is taking ARVs as prescribed. If the mother is not on ARVs, formula feeding or safe alternatives to breast milk are recommended if this is a feasible option for the mother. If the child is under 6 months of age, ask her if she is feeding the child anything other than breast milk. Mixed feeding is not recommended. If the water or food is contaminated, it can lead to infections which may injure the gut and immune barriers, putting the child at a higher risk of acquiring HIV. Number two, ask if the child has symptoms related to HIV. You can ask, does she have persistent, which means ongoing, diarrhea or coughing? Does she have white patches in her mouth or frequent rashes? Is she delayed in her growth and development compared to other children? Has she been losing weight? Does she get sick often? These are common symptoms of HIV, although the symptoms can vary depending on the age of the child and how much virus is in their body. Young children may also not have any symptoms at all. If the child has frequent infections, they should be referred for HIV testing. Number three, find out if the child has any symptoms of severe illness. You can ask, does she have a headache and vomiting, or fits or convulsions that might suggest meningitis? Is she struggling to breathe? Does she have persistent diarrhea and signs of severe dehydration? Does she have persistent fevers? Does she have severe weight loss, or is she stunted? Children with HIV are more likely to get severe infections. They should be referred urgently to a health facility if they have any of these symptoms. Number four, ask whether the child has been exposed to tuberculosis or TB. You can ask, is there anyone in the family or at home who has TB, is coughing, or is on TB treatment? Does she have any symptoms of TB, such as a persistent cough, fever, weight loss or fatigue? Children under 5 years with HIV have a greater risk of getting TB due to their weakened immune systems. TB is also a common opportunistic infection. If they have been exposed to TB, have TB symptoms, or are living with HIV, they should be referred for TB testing or preventative treatment. Refer all patients living with HIV for TB testing at least once a year, and all patients with TB for HIV testing. Once you have asked the caregiver questions about the child's symptoms, look at the child's signs. Start by looking for signs related to HIV, such as a growth delay or stunting, delays in development, a cough, difficulty breathing, a fever, a skin rash, oral thrush, which is white patches in the mouth, enlarged lymph nodes, an enlarged spleen or liver, dehydration. If the child has any signs that may be related to HIV, refer them to a health facility. Then, do a mid-upper arm circumference or MUAC measurement. If the child's result is either yellow or red, it may indicate malnourishment due to HIV. Refer the child to a health facility for further assessment. Once you have completed your assessment, you can decide if the child has signs and symptoms of a moderate or severe illness. For both illnesses, you will need to refer the child to a health facility. This process will be explained in more detail in another video. Remember that early testing and treatment are key to managing HIV. Encourage all those who do not know their status to be tested for HIV, and always protect the HIV status of your patients.